Choosing the right solar inverter isn't easy, and making the wrong choice could impact your system's performance and installation costs. In this video, we'll help you make the right pick by breaking down the 6 best solar inverters of 2025, comparing efficiency, reliability, and cost. Stick around to find out which one is the best fit for your system and how to avoid picking the wrong inverter. So Larry, before we reveal our top 6 inverter brands of 2025, what are some of the core attributes that we look for in an inverter before we make a decision to add that to our list of brands?
Yeah, so there's a host of things that we look at, Warren.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of things that every inverter brand has. I mean, of course, we're going to look at price, you know, reliability, efficiency, monitoring, feature set. Some of those things are going to be core to every brand.
Right.
But there's 3 things that I would say that kind of differentiate the brands.
Okay.
And I'll just come back to monitoring as kind of the first one.
Yeah.
So it's really important to us because of our warranties to our customers and because we want our customers to be successful. It's really important to us to be able to see what the inverter's doing, to be able to see when it's down, to be able to remotely troubleshoot and not have to come out on site.
Right.
Whether we have to pay for it or you have to pay for it as a customer, we want to be able to do that remote as much as possible, to be able to remotely restart the inverter. Some of those kinds of things. So the monitoring system is really, really important to us.
Yeah.
And then the second thing is just understanding the financial situation of the company that we're working with. You know, now assuming that these companies are public and we can see their financials. And I'll just, as a caveat there, I'll just say this. All of these companies, or most of these companies at some time, have had significant financial struggles. I mean, Enphase, yeah, you know, 10 years ago, whenever it was, they just about went under.
Yeah.
SolarEdge is having some significant challenges right now. SMA in the past has had some challenges. And so while we watch out for that, and that's important to us, more what I'm looking for there is, are they having financial challenges when the market's doing well? That's a big red flag.
Right.
Right now, it's kind of like everyone is down, the market's down, you know, what are you going to say? But that's kind of a red flag to watch out for. And then thirdly is just customer support. You know, how do they support us before we even offer the product to the customer? Do they give us the technical information? Do they help us understand how to install it? Are they willing to do training? You know, how do they work with us? And then, of course, after the fact, after you purchase the product, how do they support us when there's a problem, when there's something down? How do they support us when something happens that's unusual, that they're not prepared for? And maybe it's difficult to know if it was a lightning strike or if it was an act of God or if it was an inverter issue. How do they work with us and the customer in those unique situations to bring a resolution?
Right. So I think monitoring, financial stability, and good customer support really are the core pillars of,
yep,
what we're looking for.
Yep.
An inverter.
Those are the differentiators.
Yeah. All right, Larry. So the moment we've all been waiting for, what are the top 6 brands that we offer here at Paradise Energy?
The top 6 brands of solar inverters that we offer here at Paradise Energy: SolarEdge, Enphase, SMA, Growatt, CPS, and Solectria.
Let's dive deeper into each one of those, starting off with SolarEdge. What's the use case for SolarEdge?
So the primary use case for solar is going to be roof mounts, especially complex roof mounts or roof mounts with shade. And the reason for that is they have power electronics under each module, which means that they can draw out the most production out of each solar module, even if they're at different orientations, different tilts, different shade profiles, or maybe the whole system's heavily shaded. They're able to maximize the production of each panel. In addition, the power electronics under each module complies with rapid shutdown, which is required on roof,
yep,
mounts. So it makes a lot of sense for roof mounts, and especially complex roof mounts with shade.
And how reliable are they?
We've had some reliability issues with SolarEdge, Warren. We,
yeah,
we really have here in the past. Now, we believe that this is something that SolarEdge takes serious and that they're working on, and we've seen improvements in that area, but that's something we're keeping an eye on.
And in terms of performance, how do they compare?
That's one of the things I really like about SolarEdge is their performance is really good. Total efficiency is around 97-98%, and they eliminate that module mismatch, the mismatch due to shade or you know, different degradation or different soiling factors on different modules because they have those power electronics per module.
Okay. And what about their warranty?
So the warranty is pretty good. Typically, it can be extended to between 20 and 25 years, and we receive pretty good support from them on the warranty side.
And in terms of features, what do they offer that other inverters may or may not offer?
Again, SolarEdge has a very, very good set of features. First of all, they have great monitoring, you know, on the module level. And then they're also capable of integrating batteries, DC coupled batteries, which is more efficient than AC coupled. They're able to integrate batteries, load control, and EV charging kind of on the same ecosystem as their solar inverter, which is pretty cool.
Let's talk about where they're manufactured and whether or not they're here in the United States.
Yeah, so one of the cool things about SolarEdge is that all the inverters and all the optimizers that we buy from SolarEdge today currently have a U.S. manufactured option.
Okay.
Now, they might have some challenges with availability as they get that ramped up, but we can purchase those products in the U.S. Otherwise, they do some manufacturing in Mexico and Southeast Asia, but they do have a U.S. manufactured option, which means that they can help us qualify our projects for domestic content.
In terms of pricing for SolarEdge, where does that fall?
So SolarEdge is a little bit more expensive option. They're going to be a little bit on the higher side with cost. And some of that's because they have all those features. Some of that's because they have U.S. manufacturing, but they are going to be on the higher side with cost.
Let's jump into Enphase. Give us an example of a use case for Enphase.
So for Enphase, we're looking primarily at smaller roof mounts. So Enphase converts power to AC, and they move that power to lower voltage AC than what other systems do on the DC side. So because they're moving power to lower voltage, it's typically going to be for smaller roof mounts that are pretty close to the interconnection point.
You know, in terms of reliability, Larry, I remember about 10 years ago, Enphase having a real challenge, some struggles with reliability. It seems like they've overcome those challenges.
Yeah, they had a significant issue, Warren.
Yeah.
And I've been very impressed to our understanding and our experience. Now, we have a small sample size of Enphase inverters versus the number of SolarEdge inverters installed.
Right.
But in that small sample size, we've experienced pretty good reliability. And we did a factory tour in their Texas facility at Enphase. And one of the things that we noticed when we were there is the checks every so often for quality and reliability. And that's something that we've noticed in the field as well.
So let's talk about then performance. How do they perform?
Performance is pretty good, pretty high. Efficiency is typically going to be between 97.5%. And again, they also eliminate the module mismatch because you've got those power electronics under each module.
What about features?
Features is pretty good. They have excellent monitoring granularity. Each module is monitored, very good monitoring system, capable of integrating batteries and EV charger. And I put that in quotes because it is AC coupled.
Yeah.
So that makes it no different than any other inverter system that would add on an AC coupled battery. But they do have their own battery option and an EV charger, and that can be installed, you know, via their AC coupled system.
And Larry, so what about their warranty and support?
Their support has been pretty good. Again, we've had challenges with them in the past, but they've really improved. They do have the highest standard warranty in the industry at 25 years, which is pretty cool.
And then what about manufacturing here in the United States?
So as we mentioned before, we did a tour out there in Texas of their U.S. facility, which, by the way, will be linked in the description below. And they do have a U.S. manufactured option, which is pretty cool. So we can today get U.S. manufactured Enphase microinverters. Otherwise, they're going to be made in Mexico, but they do have that domestic content option to help us get there on our projects.
Yeah. And then finally, where do they fall in terms of pricing?
So in pricing, they're going to be probably a little bit more than SolarEdge. They're going to be our most expensive option that we have.
So let's talk about SMA. Give us a good use case for them.
SMA is going to be a pretty good option for ground mounts, and probably particularly for three-phase ground mounts. We haven't used their single phase, their new single phase option yet, so we're looking primarily at three-phase ground mounts.
Talk about their reliability and performance.
So SMA has been a reliable brand for many years.
Yeah.
Warren, we've had some bumps and hiccups with them along the way, but overall, they've been a pretty solid product. On the performance side, you're going to see efficiencies between 97.5% to 98%, which is really good.
Yeah.
Now, because they don't have the power electronics in each module, they're going to have some module mismatch, but that also means that the cost is lower as well.
And then what about their features and capabilities?
SMA has a great monitoring portal.
Okay.
Very, very good monitoring option there. They are capable of integrating batteries with their single-phase systems. That system, in my opinion, is not very advanced or very flexible yet, but I'm expecting some improvements there over time from SMA.
And warranties?
Warranties is reasonable for a string inverter. Standard 10 years can be extended up to at least 20 years. Some of their inverters can be extended all the way to 25 years.
And what about domestic content? Where they're manufactured?
So right now, they're all manufactured in Germany, and okay. they don't have a domestic content option. So they're still manufactured in Europe and Germany, still a great quality product, but they don't have domestic content.
And where do they fall in terms of pricing?
So they're going to be cheaper than SolarEdge or Enphase. Again, yeah. you don't have those module level power electronics, but so it's going to be a cheaper product.
So let's talk about Growatt. Where would we use these?
Growatt is a great option for single phase ground mounts. So SMA is an option, Growatt's an option. What I like about Growatt is they have a larger inverter than what SMA has. They have an 11.4, which is a great option for our larger single phase ground mounts.
And how are they in terms of reliability and performance?
We've only installed a few of these inverters so far.
Yep.
So far, so good.
Okay.
We've been pleased with what we've seen so far. On the performance side, they're typically going to be between 97.5% to 98%. So they're going to be a pretty good performing product.
What about their feature set?
Features, good monitoring. Again, so far, so good with what we've seen. They are capable of integrating batteries, but like SMA, it's not very flexible, and I'm expecting them to integrate additional features at some point. Right now, we're primarily looking at them as a solar-only inverter option.
Manufacturing and domestic content options?
So manufacturing is going to be out of China or Vietnam.
Okay.
And no domestic content option at this point that we're aware of.
And what about their warranty?
Again, they come with a standard 10 years, which is pretty typical for string yep. inverters. Can be extended up to 20 years.
And then finally, where do they line up in terms of pricing?
In terms of price, they're going to be your most economical option.
So if ROI is important to you, that's a good option.
Yep.
Let's talk about CPS. Where would you use these inverters?
So CPS has three-phase inverters, and what we found a good fit for these inverters is kind of the mid-sized system. Let's say anywhere from like 50 kW up to several hundred kW, maybe even up to a megawatt or larger three-phase ground mount.
And what about their reliability and performance?
Reliability, again, we haven't installed a lot of CPS inverters, but what we've seen, we've been pleased with. So far, so good there. On the performance side, again, they're going to be in that 97.5% to 98% efficiency, which is pretty good.
And jump into their features and warranties.
So good monitoring on the feature side from what we've seen so far. No integration with batteries that we're aware of, at least not for the inverter set that we use. I do know that they have some inverters that can work with batteries, but what we're using is more on the solar side. As far as warranties, again, standard 10 years can be extended up to 20.
Okay. Place of manufacturing?
Manufacturing is going to be in Thailand. So right now, no domestic content option and none in the works that we're aware of.
Okay.
So it's not going to be domestic at this point.
And cost?
Cost is going to be pretty good. They're going to be about as economical as you can get for a three-phase inverter.
And finally, Solectria. Where would you use these inverters?
So Solectria inverters we're starting to use on larger three-phase ground mounts. So it's what's called a 1500-volt inverter, which you can only use on the ground.
Yep.
And it typically only makes sense for larger projects, let's say a megawatt plus.
Okay. And how do they, in terms of performance and reliability?
Well, we don't know about reliability yet. We've not installed any of these inverters.
Okay.
Now, we have had success with a limited number of smaller inverters with them in the past. We've installed had some inverters of theirs installed for 5+ years, and we feel very comfortable with the brand. These particular inverters, the jury's still out, and we'll see where that goes. As far as performance, again, they're going to be in that 97.5%, 98%, pretty good performing product.
Okay, and what about their features and warranties?
Yeah, so features, I mean, their monitoring is awful.
Like, okay.
No doubt, no question, their Solectria's monitoring is terrible. They know it, we know it, they're not trying to change it. But here's what we can do. We can integrate a third-party monitoring platform and use that to monitor their inverter's data. So we can still have a good monitoring system. The other cool thing with Solectria is we can pay additional and get a remote access option where it's like we're standing right there in front of the inverter. We can do everything remotely as if we're standing right there. So we're going to go that route. These are larger systems. That additional cost makes a ton of sense from that perspective. So while they have really terrible monitoring, we're going to find a way to get around that and have a pretty good monitored system. As far as features, again, you know, we're not looking to integrate batteries. This is a solar only. It's kind of like it does really well at what it does, but it doesn't have a lot of extra features, and that's kind of what we're looking to do with it.
All right, so let's talk about the warranties.
So the warranty is, is going to be shorter on these than on some. It's a standard 5-year and they go up to 10. And I'll just put this caveat in there. Larger inverters tend to have shorter warranty options.
Okay.
So in this case, 5 is standard. 10 is as far as that warranty will extend.
But that's an industry standard for this size inverter.
There are some inverters in this size that will take you out to 20 and even 25 years.
Okay.
But there are some that will not. So it's the, you know, it's kind of, there's some of both.
Sure. And where are they manufactured?
This is what I'm really excited about. They're manufactured right here in the U.S. So they do have domestic content option, can help us out there with domestic content projects, and they do make product in the U.S.
And then let's talk about costs, even including the additional costs associated with monitoring or remote access.
Yeah, so cost is going to be pretty good.
Yeah.
So again, this is like, this inverter does solar, doesn't have a ton of extra features. It's really good at what it does. And the cost is low, even with the additional cost for the third-party monitoring system.
All right, Larry, so why don't you give us a quick recap of the top solar inverters of 2025?
Yep, so there's 6 brands that we've looked at. SolarEdge and Enphase are going to be your MLPE brands, module level power electronics, and they're going to be on the
roof. Okay.
Then we have 4 brands that are typically ground mount products because they're string inverters, SMA, Growatt, CPS, and Solectria. I'll just kind of go into each of these 6, give a little more detail. So SolarEdge is going to work really well with really any rooftop project that you have. It's a feature-rich inverter, does well for any rooftop. Enphase is going to be more smaller rooftop projects. And then you have the 4-string inverters. So SMA and CPS are both going to be maybe mid-size ground mounts. Growatt is a single-phase solution for small ground mounts. And then Solectria is a great option for the larger ground mount projects.
Do you want to keep learning about solar? Subscribe to our channel for honest, expert insights on all things solar energy. For additional in-depth ideas, tools, and ROI calculators, check out our Solar Learning Center, linked in the description below. At Paradise Energy, we're a family-owned, full-service solar company helping businesses, farmers, and homeowners across the Mid-Atlantic save with every sunrise. If you're ready to talk solar, connect with one of our local experts using the link in the description below. Thanks for watching.